Earl Alto just earned a spot on the U.S. national table tennis team on his first try. At 33, some consider him the old man of the new team. We consider him a neighborhood all-star. Alto earned his spot on the 14-player roster by playing in a tournament held in Texas in May. He did not qualify for the Tokyo Olympics in July, but he hopes to earn a spot in the World Table Tennis Championship and the Pan Am Games held this November. Alto also coaches at the After School Learning Tree Table Tennis Club in Sorrento Valley, and he says he does it for the pure joy.
When I tell him this, it's fun, and you could play this your whole life, even if you're not trying to be like top 10 in the country or anything like that. It's just fun. I mean, you can see the people behind me. They're out here having fun. To them, they're just hitting every ball, and it's very cerebral and physical at the same time, and I think it's just fun. So have fun. If you're 11-year-old, have fun and see where it goes.
That makes sense to me. The National Women's Soccer League will put in a... Sorrento Valley's Earl Alto just earned a spot on the U.S. national table tennis team on his first try. At 33, some consider him the old man on the new team. We consider him a neighborhood all-star. Julian Delgadio has a story.
Ball is life. For 33-year-old Earl Alto, that ball is a ping pong ball.
It's very deep. There's a lot of spin, a lot of complicated serves, a lot of weird stuff. And then there's also, for some guys, they make it more athletic, and it all counts all the same.
The Sorrento Valley man recently winning a coveted spot on the U.S. national table tennis team following a gutsy performance in a tournament in Texas.
I just went there. I tried to do my best. I was trying to just have fun. And then when I found out that I had a really good chance to make the team, I was kind of surprised, and I just took it, you know.
Alto has played table tennis since he was 11, becoming a national level coach less than 2 years ago and teaching at the After School Learning Tree Table Tennis Club.
In life, very few times in anyone's life really you get chances like that to do something that you want to do and be pretty good at it and have a chance to get to the top. So I just have fun with it.
Earl is also considered a defensive player or a chopper, hitting balls upwards of 80 miles an hour, making it really hard to defend.
It's very complicated with all the spins. And so what you have to do is you kind of have to understand what spins are really important and what spins are not. And then you have to like think about speed and different styles. So like for me, I focus, my style is defensive with a good attack on my right side. So I have to try and find a way to defend against every type of attack.
Now, Earl is not on the Olympic team, but he hopes to make the shortlist in competing at the prestigious World Table Tennis Championships and Pan American Games.
I'm so proud of him. Like, he works so hard, like every day. Like, he's always at the club, like refining his crafts and trying to get better. And like this tournament just like really proved it for him.
In Sorrento Valley, Julian Delgadio, Fox 5 Sports.